Did you see the German tech buffs? Or did we talk about it already? I can't remember.
No.
Most German techs getting buffs. That's it, fucking finally. 2 years late.
Oh my, no arty! Nom 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 nom, I'm going middle! Anyway, I might convince my wife to get a new PC.
Wait, you have enough money?
Yeah, well, my job is currently doing pretty good. And
awesome.
For our conditions in Serbia, we don't actually need that much money, so it's pretty decent.
No, decided on parts yet?
Oh, yes, mostly. I'm probably gonna get 1060 from Gigabyte and 3 gigs of video RAM. I think it's quite enough. I don't need too much of it, you know.
I might recommend 1070, you know, the price for power ratio is kind of better.
Which one?
1070. It's kind of the ideal frame rate per dollar. God.
RX 470?
No, 1070 GTX.
Oh, 1070. Oh no. It's a bit out of my price range, you know. I'm not gonna.
Isn't that much difference?
Well, it is. Because GTX 1070 is like 200 euros.
200 only?
Yeah. Because it has 3 gigs of VRAM.
1060, you mean?
Yeah, 1060. I told you 1060, didn't I?
Oh, yeah.
I think I have.
Only 200. It's
yeah.
Really that low. Fuck me.
And it's much more power efficient than RX 470 that I wanted to get. You know?
Yeah, of course. It's only 200. I thought it was more. I mean, 1070 is like, what, 400, 500?
Yeah, this is what... It's definitely out of my price range. So this is why I wanted the 1060. I prefer AMD's video cards so far, because they've been quite reliable for a couple of years. But hopefully the Gigabyte's gonna make a good fans on this one, and it's gonna last for couple of years at least. I'm gonna get i5 66k probably, so I can perhaps OC it later. Also gonna get a new Gigabyte Gaming 7 motherboard, Z270X chipset, which should be quite powerful enough to handle next 10 years of upgrades. And for the start, I'm just gonna get 8 gigs of RAM. There's just no game which needs much more than that.
True.
And I don't actually plan to game on, I don't know, 4K, 180p is just enough. I don't need it, actually.
What?
probably gonna get one M.2 module, like 120 gigs for Windows and such shit.
Sounds pretty solid.
Yeah. Well, unless my wife kills me, yeah.
What monitor are you gonna be using?
I still haven't decided. So I might buy a monitor later, maybe next month when I get a little bit more money. For now I'm gonna use this old one, you know. Until, you know, I can't really...
What's the frame rate and resolution on that?
On this one? Well, I don't know.
You can check on this top quite quickly.
720p, I think.
Oh.
Yeah, well, it's an old
and
one.
You need to upgrade if you want any advantage of that hardware you're buying.
I know. Eventually I will upgrade it, but at the moment, I'm just content to get some decent hardware. But later I can always, you know, get a new monitor.
It's gonna not do quickly some FPS benchmarks on a 1060.
Trust me, I've been doing some research of my own. Wow, this gun! I remember Pershing being a little bit more accurate, no?
Pershing's many things, but accurate? Hell no. Surprisingly good at 1440. Bad.
Kurva, match. Yeah, this is why I'm getting it. 1060 proved to be good value for money.
Yeah, I'm surprised at these benchmarks.
It's not the top notch, but it can handle itself pretty decently.
I'm waiting for the 1080 Ti. Should be coming next month.
I mean, I'm probably gonna wait before the AMD releases Ryzen. Because I think the Intel's gonna lower the prices just a little bit at least. I hope.
I hope Ryzen's good.
I do. I also hope Ryzen's good. I would love to the Intel get some proper competition so we can actually,
yeah,
you know, get some lower prices, less monopoly, and some good performance and some better upgrades. Like, Intel has been rising from series to series like 5 to 10%, not even that. It's ridiculous. The new Kaby Lake is like just 7% faster than Skylake. Not even worth getting.
I think the model, the business model, was 10% better performance per clock tick every generation. About. That's light gigahertz improvements, just light.
Yeah.
That's just it.
I'm just hoping that AMD has been doing okay with, you know, big cores, large number of cores, but their single core performance have been always lacking behind Intel's. And this is why Intel is primary choice for gamers, because most games still can't parallelize that much. So yeah, most they just games
use two default cores at best.
Yeah, yeah. And that's even to put it, you know, put it that's too optimistic. Even some games engines just use single core. Like World of Tanks, it's not actually multi-CPU usage. It just uses one CPU, CPU core for, you know, game engine, and the multi-core support is actually Sound uses the second core, which is, yeah.
I don't know why Wargaming is so bloody lazy that they cannot make a game engine for multiple cores.
Well, to be frank, it's not that easy. If you think it's easy to parallelize gaming code, it's not, because
I mean, it's not easy, but World of Tanks isn't exactly the most complicated game.
True.
Kerbal Space Program, right? A tiny indie developer, made its engine from
life.
64-bit. Artillery prevents camping. Doesn't it?
Yeah. Well, I'm dead anyway.
But yeah, back to Kerbal Space Program, the example. From Unity 4.7 to Unity 5, they just took a new engine. I'm not sure if they almost remade the game, but it was a lot of work.
Which game?
Probably half a year at least. But they did it.
I don't know that game.
Well, if you get a new PC, they said the old one couldn't handle it.
Hmm.
And you should try it.
I will try a lot of new things, but I got my hands on Witcher 3, probably.
Oh, Witcher 3! Recommend you get a vacation for that one. Because you don't want to stop.
I mean,
have you played the Witcher series before, though?
No, I haven't. I've been playing, how it's called, I forgot the name. Fuck my life.
Enemy armor is hit.
Oh, Dragon Age, that's what I wanted to say. I played the Dragon Age series.
Light tech on your ass.
Well, yeah. And no one's shooting him, so.
Well, there's no one here.
We have a camping light, so that's, you know, GG. And their art is wrecking us, like.
Witcher 3. I think Angry Joe was accurate on that one, that it's a 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
Well, the gameplay isn't exactly the most complex, but it's complex enough. Depends on the difficulty as well.
Yeah, well, you don't need the game to be complex. You just need it to be complex enough not to get boring.
And my god, the story and the atmosphere.
Yeah, I can only imagine, because RPG is as good as the story it tells. But I am looking forward to actually playing Homeworld Remastered in full graphic details. I can run it now, but it kinda lags when the battle starts. It's okay as long as I'm building and just doing shit around them. mothership, but once I start building shit, I mean, the battle starts, yeah, it's just...
But I mean, I want to finish that Witcher 3. I mean, what I mean about atmosphere is not just the graphics, which are good, but my god, the audio quality. I mean, you can hear the trenches cracking. The leaves make that sound.
That's good of an audio engine?
Yeah, it's just... The sound, you really feel like you are in a forest when you go through a forest. When it's raining, you really feel it. And I'm driving like a complete retard. And of course my Amaraki is damaged. Oh, it is the engine.
Don't go there! T-92.
I just want this fuck dead.
Well, that escalated fast.
I know! Three tanks can kill... Four snipers and they can kill me too. In 10 seconds. Yeah, that's fine. And then in Witcher 3 you have to make a hard choice. There are a lot of hot women and you can only romance one.
You can only what?
Romance one.
Ah.
Because you're roleplaying against Geralt.
No. I just don't care about those things.
Oh, come on! Well, if you check the background or the backstory, because it's the ending of the Witcher series, which has multiple novels and multiple games before it. And yeah, I have to say, you really should play Witcher 3 before. Because you really get attached to the characters. You know who they are. They help you ask in missions.
But I am looking forward to the Mass Effect.
Mass Effect.
What? You didn't like Mass Effect?
No, it's just after Dragon Age Inquisition that I've kinda lost faith in BioWare. I mean, it was such a nosedive. Especially Dragon Age 2. Fuck Dragon Age 2. Ugh.
Yeah, it was very bad. I couldn't agree. The Dragon Age 1 was just amazing, so immersive, and I've been playing it for... Oh, it was just...
Dragon Age 2 had so laughable graphics. I mean, the city... It really looked like...
Okay, start the game. Because I have a clan's mission for 600k.
But how come you don't care about romancing anyone in role-playing games?
Because, I get bored when I need to talk to characters. I mean, at first, it starts very interesting, for example, Star Wars, the Knights of the Old Republic, just amazing dialogues, amazing story. And after some time you just get bored and just click, 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 let's get going already. you know that feeling. Of course you do.
Not in Witcher 3.
You think?
Well, if you think it's going to blow any other RPG I've ever played out of the water. Mass Effect looks like a crappy soap opera compared to Witcher 3's writing. I mean, I don't lightly give that game 10 out of 10, but Witcher 3... You care about it on a whole new level. Yeah, I'll stop on D54. I guess we'll answer.
I'm on reload.
Well, you'll have to play The Witcher 3 in order to see it.
Yeah, well, this is why I do want to play it. I want to try it different. I'm not sure how much time I'm going to have.
It's going to take at least 40 hours to finish.
So basically that's 1 month for me.
That's a few days for me.
Well, you don't have a wife and you don't have a work, so...
That's why I don't get them. I can spend all the time by myself.
Oh, I hate the accuracy on this gun. I hate it. I mean, the tank is great, but the accuracy... The accuracy is just shit. Donkey shit. Scheiße. And as I have read so many reviews of the CPUs, I think the 66K is like the best choice I could make. At least for gaming. Like, you don't actually need an i7.
Because... Oh, i7 is for editing videos and such.
Yeah, but I'm not gonna edit any videos. Penetration. I've been working on my YouTube channel, but I just don't have time to just start and... Oh, stop snapshotting me!
Why not? Let's go forward, I get fucked.
Just go on the right side because of the TDs on the fucking hill.
Ah, bounce off. It has to hit the upper plate.
Stop pushing me, i7 shitter. Arta, kill the bitch.
Right.
Pin your shots, mate. I'm gonna kill our ISM. I'm gonna kill our... Fucking blo- Ooh. Fuck my life.
Oh!
That had to hurt, just that even hurt me. Ooh, fuck. I thought DFA was on hill.
Me too.
How can you?
The Bachelor is gonna try to shoot me at this rate.
I'm not afraid of the Bachelor, to be frank.
You should.
He's not gonna come. He's too afraid.
But the reason I'm Pussy. Excited about the latest Mass Effect is because the writing has been going kind of down with BioWare. I mean, the Old Republic, Knights of the Fallen Empire expansion, it has been just a slow decline. A special Inquisition. That was bad.
Wow, that one bounced. Can you be more lucky, bad shit shit?
Well, all you need is hill of 12 degrees and you got yourself an auto bounce. Armor or bad shit. Yep. He's gonna rush him, and then he's gonna rush you. Well, basically all you have to do is rush the Banshee.
Nine 903 roll. What the fuck was that? 900 roll from a fucking RHM.
Maybe he
shot an
explosive at you.
Come on, 900? Seriously? Fuck my life.
It was highly explosive.
Most
if
likely.
It was
really
900.
But still.
Well, the average damage of HE is 900, so that's nothing special.
Yeah, I can't believe that we're gonna win because Levi is camping in the fucking ditch. Look at him. And he's a complete moron. The object's gonna flank him and he's gonna kill him because an idiot. Wow. So much skill. But that roll, 903. I could have owned DFV TD, like I could have just tracked him and raped him, but yes, Levi, go and let DFV one shot you. Of course, he's wearing a Turkish flag because kebab. Yes, I'm racist, so
Akro. That's not racist! The nation is not a race, what did you say?
Kebab shit.
Everyone's using that racism word so many times that it doesn't mean anything anymore. If I don't want immigration in my country, I'm a racist.
You are. Of course you are.
If I don't support affirmative action, which is if half of company's employees are women, then that company gets fined because feminism. If I disagree with that, I'm a sexist.
And you are a sexist. You are a sexist. Come on, be frank.
No, I'm not.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. And they shoved identity politics in Dragon Age Inquisition.
Should subscribe. Cause I'm that good.
I'll give you a sub.
There we go.
Oh, it's Twitch.
Wow, thank you.
I mean, transgender in Dragon Age Inquisition, I was like, what the hell? Not that there are transgender people, but I mean, medieval times. People are killed for lesser reasons. I mean, it's not a time where you can worry about your gender identity. And these tiny, ridiculous problems. First world problems that don't exist in that time. There's a demonic invasion. All kinds of other shit.
No.
Now there are what, 80 genders now?
Come on. Of course it's important. I mean, like, you can't make a game where you can't have a gay friend, you know? You just have to have a gay friend there.
Yeah, there are more gay people than there are straight people in Dragon Age Inquisition. I think it was 33%. There are two straight characters, then there are two... almost, there are two lesbians and there are two bisexuals. This is like a... what is this world? I'm sorry, but 95% of the world's population, at least, is straight.
Hmm. Are you sure?
And if you put that into... squeeze into 20 characters, you get one! That is either gay, or more bisexual, or whatever.
Nah, I think they are making, a porn. That's why they need so many different, you know, sexual preferences.
Yeah, they're pansexuals, where you're attracted to a frying pan.
Pansexual.
I'm thankful that that lunacy hasn't reached Finland yet. But feminism is creeping in here. Slowly.
There's time. Don't worry. There's time. Where are we going?
We go right, we get rape artillery, we go rapid fire, we go left. We'll get your weak spot snipe because our Jesus. This fuck you. Yeah.
can't wait for E5 nerf. And now I7s will camp there and fuck my life. Reload.
And this. I'll go help me fall.
No. Let's make a crossfire. What? Oh, fuck my life. Now I have to stay here. I wanted to go on the left so we can create a crossfire.
I wanted to just save his E4, but he doesn't want to save himself.
Yeah, he's idiot. Look at him. Look, what is he doing? What? Wow.
Up the wall, I got shot through the roof. Oh, come on.
You need to press the forward, because they're gonna shoot me. I'm gonna protect your back. You need to press forward.
There is no road forward or backwards, they're just gonna say fuck you anyway. Okay, I'm gonna play a tech that I'm more used to.
DOP5?
Nah, D57 heavy.
Ah. I thought you're gonna take a Krennwagen. Krakenwagen.
It's Krennwagen.
No, it's Krakenwagen. Release the Kraken.
Well, it's a slightly better 5120 with gun depression.
Oh no, kurwa mat. Krakenwagen! Kill the bitch! Now it's more funny to say Krakenwagen. Isn't it?
Maybe.
We just need some Finnish tanks now.
Finnish have made actually some tanks, but... they're too embarrassing to show. More like armored cars than anything else. Fuck this map! This is why I left one of tanks for half.
So wait, what do you think of my new computer?
Your new what?
Computer.
What the hell's that?
Computer.
You'll have to speak English.
No England, just wait. Retarded language.
Well, if you want me to understand, that is.
Well, what do you think of the specs I gave you?
Everything sounds solid. Solid choices, but you're gonna have to spend some money on the monitor if you want anything out of it.
Yeah, I will.
It's gonna have to be at least 1080p 60.
Yeah, yeah.
I might
I've been looking at
something higher with rates.
I've been looking at those, and they're like 100 euros here. 1080p monitors are no longer that expensive like they used to be.
I recommend using humanoid parts a bit extra.
I'm gonna do my research like I did on entire hardware so far. And I'm choosing Gigabyte for most of my hardware because I'm quite confident in their, you know, quality. I wouldn't go there if I were you because three fucking artists. And
I'll take my chances. I don't want a catball game. I'm just fucking.
I know.
I'm just done trying anything on this map anymore. I want to hit Quick Baby in the face because he praised this map. That it's tactical.
This map is tactical?
Yeah, wow. This map is very tactical.
Yeah.
I mean, it has the same fucking problem on every front. If you are two opposite ends on the left side, everyone camps in bushes, anyone tries to bush gets shot from invisibility and dies. And there's also a crossfire from middle.
Well, this is why Quickie Baby likes it, because he's a camper shit.
That actually makes sense.
Well,
the middle. It's the same story. You try to turn your turret to the right, you get shot from the front. If you try to go forward, you get shot from the flank. And the exact same situation is here as well.
It's so like you never watched Quickie Baby. Don't you know he's a camping bitch? I'm spotted.
I don't
so...
watch any of his live streams. I just watch some of his videos on updates and tech reviews.
Yeah.
Because I like someone saying, you know, explaining the stats and such.
Yep.
I prefer Sir Bosch, but he doesn't always make videos. You think it maybe he's faster after the first to tell something.
I prefer this game. There's guns. There's... I don't know.
I love his voice.
He's good.
I love his voice, but as a... I disagree with him a lot. I'll just say that.
What?
I just love his voice.
Yeah, he has an amazing voice.
I don't know what that accent is, but I love it. And funny enough, that was the reason I subscribed to him. Just because of that voice.
I didn't hit anything so far.
I'll say hello to this map. Either you get to shoot or you get shot.
I loaded some hits because Quickie Baby told me that. Hits are needed. What was that guy thinking? Like, he got shot from me and you, and then he
maybe
kept
he
staying
up.
There. Yeah, maybe.
I can't blame him. This map is depressing.
Okay, I wouldn't mind if everyone comes to me and... But one by one, just so I can reload in time, you know? Would be nice if we could get some spotting out here. But yeah, I guess that's not gonna happen. Boring.
Do you watch Sir Fosh, by the way?
Nope.
I like to hear him rant and just destroy Wargaming on everything. I mean, there's no other polite language, it's just straight, this is fucking retarded about the sandbox changes and...
Wrecked. Rest in peace, mate. Rest in peace.
Artillery is so much fun.
I don't know what that scout is doing. La 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 la. La 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 la.
I mean, do you ever feel like when you watch a YouTuber that's maybe it's something one of text, there's just this strange, over polite, you know, almost politically correct language?
Only on big channels. On small channels, it doesn't matter. Well, it's because, YouTube has, child protection system, and you have to log in and to be 18 in order to,
I find it detestable almost. Especially when it's so undeserved. I mean, take what Wargaming has done in the last 3 years. It's surprisingly little, besides adding new tanks. And many of the changes have been basically stat reversing. It's quite funny if you look at the history of AMX50B, for example. It was their first after it was released. And little by little, they reversed every single nerf that you ever got. I find it quite funny. I mean, first it was the aiming time, the time between shells, dispersion on the book, dispersion when turning the turret, all restored, bit by bit. HP nerf as well, all of it. Ish tanks, Czechoslovakian tanks, Stein's tanks, well, new tanks, basically. And assault and encounter. You have to buy gold. All over plate.
We didn't even scratch them.
Just fuck off. Burn, baby, burn. Piece of cake. Yep, I have a dead engine, I have an Amarok gun. Because I listened to it, it's good spot. Yes! ML2 is just a great spotting tank, just made for spotting. Fucking ridiculous. Boom.
Ready to fire.
Oh, I killed him! Unbelievable. But the art is gonna click me anyway.
I'll be surprised if I three darts to shoot you. We float. Panther's taking the offensive.
Revenge is a dish best served cold. And I, now I reload. Yeah. Now I load 70 seconds. Fucking hell. Okay, next game, please.
Well, might as well chit chat while we're at it. Nothing else to do. Well, the one thing I have to praise Wargaming about is what they're doing now with the next update.
I can't wait for German mouse to be actually mouse. Oh, and I'm so gonna have fun in Type 5. It's gonna be ridiculous.
I mean, well, the tech ship have good armor. It's the only thing it has. I'm like, finally something that doesn't simply turn to butter when you load press the 2 key.
Yeah. Boom 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 boom.
I mean, there's so much cringe when I hear about talking about armored tanks in lower tiers. I mean, take a look at tier 8 and tier 9 tanks. They face what? 300 to 350 millimeters of penetration.
What? And that's it.
I mean, any tech with a tier 10 gun gets... yeah, the 300 to 350 millimeters of penetration. I'm like, what armor holds against that?
What?
Now, I just ranting about how worthless armor is. Because most tanks have, what, 300... let me just a penetration plus on the premium rounds.
Yeah.
I mean, if you angle the mouse perfectly, you get roughly about 300 everywhere. Or 290.
Yeah. But
yeah,
still.
Just look golden. Shoot wherever you want.
Exactly. It's not like they're hitting your weak spot, they're just shooting randomly. And...
sure, it's a big fat weak spot. They sound like Yak Pants 800, 420 millimeters of heat penetration.
Not piece bad. Of cake.
And then there's the IS-3A, which has 1,300 millimeters of armor on the gun. 1,339.
Yeah.
That was hilarious.
Our Becetati flip.
More armor than any modern world, many modern tanks today. Overturned that vehicle, what the hell does that mean?
Yeah, he fell on his roof.
Awesome. This is why I like World of Warships more. No gold ammo.
Oh my god! Did you see that?
No, I just left.
Did you fucking see that? Check the stream. Check the stream. Did you see it?
Just checking the stream.
You can like go back 1 minute or so. Did you see it?
Yeah, now I did.
Like, I just saw, like, Shell flying, and I couldn't believe it. He actually hit it. He has to be some kind of cheater. There's no way from the entire map he actually hits him. Come on. And of course, 3-18 platoon. I like what they've done to World of Warships, that you can only take one carrier in a platoon.
Yeah. Carriers are kind of back again.
For some reason.
Carriers are back.
What do you mean back?
I mean, you see them more often. You actually see one per game almost.
Yep. I tried some battles in my midway, but no, not really that good. Yeah, I do. I suck terribly.
Yeah, I found the Lexington kind of tough. I actually did 140,000 damage on average and still lost over half games.
Yeah, I have something like a similar average in my tier 10, which is ridiculous. Even on Essex I have more. After they nerfed the fucking US carriers so hard, it's ridiculous. Okay. Fuck my life, I'm not going there. By the way, I think the Japanese carriers are still OP. I've been doing great in those.
But I've never seen you in World of Warships. Can we just play at a different time or something?
Well, I just enter, play one or two games. I don't even stay that long.
You need to try the new captain skills.
Yeah. I watched Jingles explain the new skills for some cruisers, which have 150mm guns and how DHE penetrates everything. Did you see that video?
Use IFHE on my Lolanta. Get
going. Yeah, it the video is just ridiculous. Like, you could pen everything and deal like 5k damage every volley. Yeah.
Well, it's not actually 5k everywhere, but it depends on the ship. I do kind of like the idea they move to actual straight damage. Boys, though, just fires everywhere.
No, I mean the HE pen skill.
Yeah, that's it. Great damage is a fire charge because if you don't pen, you don't do any damage.
Oh my god! Are these teams gonna learn to play? I'm so pissed.
This is why I play World of Warships. I can actually carry that.
Yeah. And look at this shit. Every fucking time I see T49 in my team, I know he's gonna camp and trying to do damage because that's what a fucking light tank should do.
Moin got a buff. 5.5 second reload.
Like it needed one.
It did.
Yeah, sure it did. Yeah.
A small one. But Nimoy is actually the bottom performer of all tier 10 cruisers.
I thought that was the Zhao.
Zhao's the top performer. It has always been strong.
I don't have that kind of experience. Like,
have you ever played the Zaw?
I haven't actually, but what I saw in games and its AA is terrible. The guns are turning slowly, and the caliber is
best in the game of cruisers. Is that Moskva, of course, because of Russia.
I think the Moskva. Moscow. Moskva. Moskva. Has the best guns, you know. Isn't it?
Well, I played it kinda, but... Well, Moskva has its own flaws. And the ridiculously bad stealth is one. Not that long again. Yeah, of course, Dust 2 and the Dutch telecom system. Permanent D-track. Why not? Why not?
I like the idea where they're gonna finally introduce the consumables with cooldown.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, but unfortunately we have to wait till fucking Sandbox comes alive. Oh, fuck my life. Okay, I have time for just one game and then I have to work.
Work at this time.
Yeah. Well, in China it's 6 a.m.
Ah, it's midnight here.
So. Time to do something fun, you know? Fun!
I wish that was possible.
Tell me you don't have a free... Oh no. Such a noob.
Can I join this before it's there? Then I'll sell this tech.
Well, it's not gonna be a big nerf. Just the cupola.
Yeah, nothing else. Just the one aspect that made it what it was. So strong. Yeah, that's not much.
Yeah, ridiculously strong. It's not strong, it's OP.
Well, it's only as effective as Type 5 heavy frontal armor.
Only.
But what makes E5 overpowered is the fact that it's almost like it made battle tag. Hide the lower plate and you have yourself a medium tank almost, but armor. Too many flaws covered.
The other two won't reload in
time. Take a gun there. On the handling. And DPM down, just keep the armor. Because without the armor, what are you? A fat slow pattern? Everyone's just gonna shoot through that fat cupola.
Well, to be frank, it's not really that easy to hit it. It's still small on long range.
Long range. Right. It's only as small as a lower plate.
Fuck my life. Why are there so many tanks on your flank?
I have no idea! This is fucking crazy!
Fuck my life, I haven't seen so many tanks on this map, on this flank, I don't know, even on encounter. Even on encounter. Oh my god! Fuck off. Okay, I should have taken the other RV. It's more accurate than this ship.
Ah! Yeah, don't tame it all.
Back. Sorry, I suck.
I'm not doing much better here. I don't think the Japanese carriers are overpowered at all.
Why?
Well, Zoe Hollows is in air dominance easily. Same here for Yoshu. Iryu has paper planes, Chicago's. Well, then you start meeting high tier battleships already at that point. Haven't tried Taiha yet. And Taiha and Hakaria lose in air superiority. But mostly because there are so many cruisers. They're so popular right now.
Yeah.
A battleship AA has reached new heights. I mean, on my Missouri, I get 420 DPS on my mid-range guns.
Another, oh, you got the Missouri?
With the long-range guns and 200 with close-range guns.
Oh, you got the Missouri.
Of course I did. I got it almost as soon as I saw the review. It was another Iowa.
I saw the guy like making a Trump video about Missouri.
I
It was a good video. I like the video though.
But you won't get that many one shots.
Nah, it's true, it's true. He does says that, but still, the amount of credits, you're never gonna buy any other premium. You won't ever need it.
I buy premiums because I like them, because they are unique. Not necessarily because they just be credits. But yeah, misery makes a lot. I mean, one game managed to pull off 1.3 million or what it was.
Fucking hell.
Yeah.
That's yeah, and it costs like 40k? Well, to convert, 700, right?
750,000 free experience.
Fuck my life. So it's like 40k?
30. A gold.
Hmm, still. Quite a lot.
Fuck it, Iowa, and there's an Iowa with a radar that makes credits. No, it was a no-brainer.
Oh, okay, that's it from me. Someone needs to earn the new computer.
good luck.
Thank you. Well, I'm gonna see you tomorrow, most likely. Tomorrow I don't have classes, so we can play a little bit longer.
I wish we could try one of warships at some time.
Oh, we can. Tomorrow.
But seriously, Zhao is crazy strong. AP, the AG, put a range module, just wow. And the AE is actually not that weak.